Good morning, everyone. We're continuing in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch in the laws of Kiddusha Shabbos, the sanctity and the preparation for Shabbos. And today we're going to speak about the great mitzvah of making challah fresh each week for Shabbos. Haminag b'chol Yisrael, the custom amongst all of Klal Yisrael, because that's how it was anyway in the days of the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch 150 years ago. La'afayis bebateim l'chamim l'chot Shabbos. They would bake bread in their homes in honor of the Shabbos. Not only if a person during the week would eat bread that was baked by a baker that was not Jewish, which means they were eating really non-Jewish baked bread, which the Shulchan Aruch says a person is allowed to do. Sheyesh lizar lechol b'yom Shabbos kodesh. Of course, that person has to be careful that on Shabbos itself, the holy day, pas Yisrael, they should only eat bread that was baked by a Jew. Certainly, that's how it should be, because it's a form of honoring the Shabbos to eat the food that is baked by the Jewish people, and on the Shabbos kodesh, on the holy day, to eat bread that is baked by a non-Jew, that would not be an appropriate honor of the Shabbos. Ella, however, even if during the week you're very careful to only eat bread that was baked by a Jewish baker, you go to the bakeries and you have what's called Pas Yisrael, which means that is bread, Jewish bread, bread that was baked by a Jew. Nevertheless, even though that you're already doing that, in honor of the Shabbos, you should bake the bread in your home. Why? Because you want the fragrance, you want the house to smell like Shabbos. That's a residual effect that you get. There's nothing like a home that has the smell of fresh challah baking on Erev Shabbos, true. However, the reason is, Kedesha Tekai Ma'isha Mitzvah Hafrashas Challah. We want a woman to fulfill the mitzvah of Hafrashas Challah, separating a portion of the dough that must be separated after she kneads the dough together. Now, we learned this in chapter 35 many, many, many months ago. You'll have to review in your notes to see all the details over there. Now, what is so important about a woman before Shabbos doing Hafrashas Challah and taking Challah? Ki Adam Arisha Nivra Be'erev Shabbos. Adam, the first man, was created on Erev Shabbos Friday afternoon. And he is known, in the words of Chazal, our sages, as the challah of the world. Which means what? Just as when the dough is kneaded, there's a portion that is removed, and it's elevated to a level which is called challah, so too, man was removed, so to speak, from the entire creation, and he was elevated to a higher level of creation and avodah and service of God that the rest of the world is not able to attain. So therefore, Adam HaRishon is called Chalasa Shel Olam. He's the Chala of the world. So in the end, V'Aisha Becheta Ibdahu. However, his wife Chava, she made a big mistake. She ate from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. She gave it to her husband as well. And as a result of that, she caused him spiritual and even physical destruction through her sin. And therefore he lost his special status. And therefore a woman has to fix and correct this sin. How does she do it? She does it by taking challah. Since that she took away the challah shel olam, the challah of the world, which was man, so she is mesakin, and she fixes that sin by taking challah on Erev Shabbos, which was the time that it took place so many thousands of years ago. The custom is to make three different loaves of bread. Gadol, ubeinani, v'katayin. Large, medium, and small. Habeinani, the medium-sized loaf, l'sudas halayla. That you should use for the nighttime meal. V'agadol, l'sudas hayayim. And the largest loaf you should use for the daytime meal. L'harayis kichvad hayayim adif. To demonstrate that honoring the Shabbos during the day takes precedence over honoring the Shabbos at night. And that means, the Mishnah Berurah writes over here, that you should reserve the finest of foods for the daytime meal and not necessarily the nighttime meal, which very often we do the opposite. The roast and the fine wines and the potatoes and the rice and all of that, and the great desserts, and that normally comes Friday night. And Shabbos day, we have a much more simpler meal, a cholent, maybe a little schnitzel, maybe a potato kugel or something like that. However, from here we learn that a person should make sure to have something during the daytime meal which exceeds that which was given during the nighttime meal. Ve'akotan, and the smallest loaf, l'seuda shlishis, that will take place for the third meal, the smallest meal of the Shabbos. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. We look forward to continuing in the laws of preparing for Shabbos tomorrow. All the best.